What is up, fellow benchwarmers? Welcome to the Valentine's episode of our daily fantasy quickie. All right, Commissioner. Happy yes. Valentine's.
Happy Valentine's. Nasa date ako eh.
Oo nga, eh, mukhang nasa date si Commissioner. Eh. Walang ano eh, walang video eh.
Pero kahit nasa date, siyempre.
Quickie pa rin, oo.
Importante, oo.
Quickie pa rin. Oh. Sige, para hindi maabalang date ni Kumish, dire-diretso yun na natin. Uy, hindi, mamaya ako sabihin. Mitch Rob!
Yun, Mitch Rob. Ilang weeks ba?
4 to 6 weeks out. Hold?
Relatively good news na yun, in my opinion.
4 to 6 weeks. Uh-oh. So, makabalik siguro siya just in time. No?
In sa time pa for the playoff.
Abot ka pa before the playoffs.
Week 15. Siya. Week 15 eh. So, maaga pa.
Oo. Maaga pa. And, like we said, it's a hand injury. So, I think, mas madali makabalik from a hand injury than maybe a knee or an ankle injury.
True. Yes, correct.
And, ano rin, yung, ano ba yung sabihin ko? And New York is in the playoffs. I mean, it's a playoff hunt. So
surprisingly, yes.
So it wouldn't seem like they will tank and let Mitch Rob play. So I think hold niya yan if meron kayong IL.
Ang interesting kung ano nangyari dun sa rotation nila today. First game without Mitch Rob is gone.
Surprisingly, nagulat ako nag 32 minutes in Nerlens.
Oo nga.
Which is
nga.
Good news for Nerlens owner.
Good and bad. Kasi hindi naman kaya ni Nerlens eh. Di ba? Baka may injury din siya kung gano'n. Pero I doubt this will be, ano eh. I doubt that would be the norm. Kumbaga, feeling ko matchup based yung kanina eh. They were up against Houston nata, tama?
Parang.
Oo, Houston. And siguro, DeMarcus Cousins, they wanted to match up with the size of Cousins, di ba? Kaya medyo maraming minutes to Noel. But I expect Julius Randle to get a lot of time as small ball center.
So lalong magkatataas ang usage ni
Randle, yeah. Yes. So lalo pag kanwari kalaban nila, let's say Brooklyn,
yeah.
Miami, yan, di ba? Brooklyn, Miami.
Contenders talaga.
Or Boston, yan mga yan. Wala namang malaking centers mga yan eh. So sa East kasi, aside from Embiid, parang it's a very small, relatively small conference, di ba?
Yeah, it's a medyo thin sa ano, sa center. Yes.
So Randle is my primary beneficiary of this trade. Si Taj Gibson, he can maybe move on na. I don't think it's gonna be valuable at all.
Yun. Mitch Robinson, I think hold if you have IL, if wala na kayong IL. Medyo may value pa yan, pero definitely very low ang offers for Mitch Rob. So, pero I think worth the wait naman 4 to 6 weeks if kaya yung season. Alright, so yun yung New York front. Big risers tayo for today. Devin Booker, umiinit na.
Oo, finally umiinit na. Pero sinabi nga natin, di ba, buy low ng time na yun. And I think yung nakaka-help sa kanya yung injury ni Chris Paul.
May injury ba si Chris Paul now?
Hindi, wala ngayon. Nung time na na-injured si Chris Paul, one or two games, tapos parang nag-ano siya eh. Parang dun siya uminit. He was able to get most of the usage. The ball was in his hands. Tapos The rhythm was there, I guess. So, moving forward, ano siya? The old Devin Booker, in my opinion.
Pero ano pa rin? Wala masyadong defense but very good in terms of scoring, threes, and not for a scorer, si Booker doesn't really give you bad percentages.
Totoo.
So, at least there's that. Hindi kayo magsasuffer sa field goal nyo. Kahit
pero si Booker for me is one tier lower pa rin than Jimmy Butler. Kung bumalik si Paul George, Jimmy Butler, Bradley Beal, I think lower siya this year. Last year kasi he was almost at the same level. This year yun pa rin with what we said before about Phoenix being a winning team and everything, di ba? Still holds true. Pero at least he's better now. I mean, scoring-wise, I think he's gonna pick up.
And sa Phoenix, there are really just probably just two players who are really nandun sa top tier types of players in fantasy, Chris Paul and Devin Booker.
Yes, yes, correct.
The rest, medyo ano na eh, even Ayton bumaba, Mikal Bridges bumaba na rin in terms of value niya. And even if mataas yung rankings nila, they aren't as consistent as Chris Paul and ano, and Booker.
Although si Mikal Bridges, I think is a very good buy low player right now. Maybe may top buy low player si Mikal Bridges.
Attack agad. Alright, Eric Gordon of Houston.
Ito,
ang Houston is like ano eh, the Orlando Magic of the West.
Oo, yun nga.
Halos
pero
wala
the good news
players.
Is PJ Tucker naglaro. Si Oladipo hindi. So I think the injury of Oladipo must be a little more serious. Alam ko may MRI pa raw yan eh. So let's wait for the update. Pero si Eric Gordon ang for me ang big winner here.
And he played
more
well
than
today.
John Wall. Yeah, more than John Wall for me. Eric Gordon.
John Wall would most likely be the same. Kung ano yung value niya before. Most likely ganun pa rin.
Feeling ko siguro may konting... Siyempre mas maraming time sa kanya yung bola. Pero for me, Eric Gordon pa rin talaga. Kasi scoring wise, he's gonna be expected to score... Most points,
diba? Yeah.
I mean, siya yung
titira. Ito, maganda yung stat line niya today, what he gave today. 24 points, 2 rebounds, 6 assists, 1 steal, 1 block, 0 turnovers.
Yep. Yes.
So, ano to, hindi mukhang, ano, waiver type of stat line to. Mukhang elite type of stat line to.
Siguro naman wala na sa waiver yan, no? Dapat
wala na sa waiver.
Eric Goyet. I mean, Gordon. Talagang ano yan, medyo underrated in my opinion.
Actually, totoo. Underrated. Dahil because of injury history.
So, for me ngayon, although underrated, kung medyo tumaas naman yung rank, pwede nyo ibenta. Kasi nga, sabi mo nga, injury history. Medyo yun. So, we can sell.
Medyo expected. He'll miss a game, few games here and there along the way. So, don't expect him to be... Pero, yun nga, as we said, very depleted na rin tong
Houston.
So, baka... Hopefully, mabawasan na yung mga rest niya.
Correct.
Alright. Ito, matagal na natin ito binabanggit. Danilo Gallinari.
May nagtanong dun sa post eh, bakit daw si Gallinari na daw meron. I mean, yun pa rin, di ba? Last, for me, the minutes is there. And pag panoorin mo kanina, basically, Stollins nag-small ball 5 eh. Three-man rotation for their bigs. Capela, Stollins, Gallinari. So 30 minutes is almost a given. And with 30 minutes, he should be better. Last game kasi ni Gallinari, 2 points lang eh.
Yeah,
so yung mga tao parang, di ba? Parang
yun. Hindi okay, di ba? Pero, yung context nun is that yung last
blow
game,
out.
He was ano, yung Atlanta was blown out by San Antonio. And he played 17 minutes lang. Today, he played 26 minutes.
Yes, which is nearer what I think he will end up.
Yeah, more or less, nandun siya sa 25 to 30 minutes ago.
Yes. He is value. For me, he is value. And he's for me, ganito yun eh. His ranking, his perceived value, parang mababa pa sa potential niya. So, yun yung mga buy low eh. Yun yung mga, for me, mga possible mo makuha at a good price. So, kaya namin inagay si Gallinari.
So, yun. Danilo Gallinari, well, wala na itong malamang sa waiver, although na-drop to in a few leagues. Siguro last week siguro mga last week
or a
couple
pa.
Of weeks ago maraming nag-drop dito
kayo.
So hopefully pag nakuha nyo di ano swerte kayo na you were able to pick him up before itong mga ano niya consistent production niya.
Tama.
Alright, last sa big risers ito favorite na to ni Tomish, TJ McConnell.
Hindi na makakalimutan yan.
Guys, hindi ko alam kung nabanggit na namin but or sa groups, pero TJ McConnell literally won Commish DFS League. One day DFS late, so today.
Oo. Oh.
Pakain ka naman. Kaya may pang date si Komi.
Oo nga eh. Actually, exacto yun, pang date talaga. Kasi talaga so, yung state. Late ko kasi TJ McConnell and Eric Gordon today. So medyo nakaano tayo. Nakatama tayo dun sa dalawang yun.
Oo.
Yung dalawang nag-carry sa akin. Pero si McConnell, I watched the game. And grabe, grabe. Buong, siguro half of the third, saka buong fourth quarter, naglaro siya. Dahil sobrang hustle player. I mean, yung steals, yung defense niya kay Trae Young, he was defending Trae Young full court.
Mm.
So, kaya siya talaga pinalaro for the whole game.
So, ayun. So, yun. Actually, matagal na natin ito binabanggit. He was part of the waiver wire. Pero is he someone that you would expect to consistently perform?
Ako, oo eh. I mean, kasi ang stat line niya usually is 4.7 assists, 2 steals. Ganun yun ang expect ko sa kanya eh.
Yeah.
Diba? It doesn't look much, right? Pero, pero yung 7 to 8 assists niya, minsan 1 to 2 steals, consistent eh. Yun yung difference, diba? So far, very consistent. So, I think yung value niya is consistent din. Kasi hindi mo naman expect from 20 points, 15 points. Eh. Diba?
Yeah.
At saka, low turnover for a guy who gets, what, 8 assists?
Yeah.
Alas mo lang turnover eh. Kaya sobrang ganda. Lalo for Roto tong si DJ McConnell. If you're playing Roto, I think it's really perfect. He's a 12-team player already, in my opinion.
Okay. 12-team player. So, 14?
14, like definitely a must own.
So yun, TJ McConnell, big risers, and papasalamatan to ni Pamish for winning him the first DFS league. Guys, if you want to join DFS leagues, go to the DFS Philippines, tama ba yung group? DFS Philippines.
DFS Philippines, yes. At, DFS Philippines.
Sali kayo dun sa group niya to join daily fantasy games. Alright, bye players natin. Dario Saric bumalik from injury.
Yun.
So, is he going to be a contributor or a fantasy relevant player?
There's a big chance na he can be because Phoenix wants to play too big, diba? So, they're using Frank Kaminsky. Saric is way better than Kaminsky. So, I think he's eventually gonna be the starter for Phoenix. So, possible.
Si Kaminsky would be a drop.
Yes, he's a drop. For me, he's a drop. Whether Saric becomes relevant or not, doesn't matter. His minutes will not be there.
Not be there anymore.
May Crowder played 32 minutes today.
Drop na Kaminsky. You could buy Saric. Either you stream him or tingnan nyo, you observe
him. Add him first, speculatively, kung may extra roster spot kayo. Tapos tingnan nyo na lang. Kasi,
kung hindi gumagawa yung last spot nyo.
Oo, next game mag-start na yan eh. May malaking chance.
Starter ba talaga siya? Ever since?
Hindi. Crowder ang starter nila eh. Pero since diba, ayaw nga nilang maliit. Gusto nilang malaki.
Yeah.
So, si Saric na talaga yung pinaka-best power forward nila. Kaminsky's a center. He's not a power forward.
Yeah. Oh.
Diba?
Oh. Tama. So, yun. Saric, another buy player. Doug McDermott nag-start today, ah. Surprisingly. Over 30, Jeremy Lamb.
36 minutes today.
Hindi ko alam kung matchup lang yan or... Pero ang hirap naman kung matchup lang kasi Doug McDermott is really not known for defense, eh.
Pero dalawang game na siya nag-start, eh. So, I think this could be the regular thing. And Doc McDermott has played 6 or 7 straight good games. Although, he's a very streaky player. Madalas rin, magbigyan mawawala. Diba?
Pero,
recent points lang siya.
Since nandun na rin tayo, is Lamb, si Jeremy Lamb, is he going to be really affected? Na tipong, you might just have to stream him or drop him at one point. Kasi ilang
games na nasasawi players kung makinambi.
Oo. Not, parang medyo may string of games na rin na hindi ganun ka-okay yung performance or slowly na bumababa yung performance niya.
I would not say he's a must-own now. Yun na lang siguro. I don't think he's a must-own. Pero to say na he's a drop, I don't think he's a drop yet. In 14-team leagues, hindi. In 12-team, he's borderline. Borderline na siya for me. Kasi, yun nga, very inconsistent siya. Ever since nung bumalik siya, na parang okay yung first few niya, after nun, sobrang inconsistent. And,
pero in fairness, he has more good games than bad ones.
Yes.
So far, ang sabi ko naman, string of ano, stats niya.
Ang sabi ko naman, ang maganda sa kanya, he gets minutes pa rin kasi very shallow ang rotation ng Indiana. Halos walang bench eh. Diba?
Pero tignan din natin kasi it might help him. Like we always say, diba? If you move back to the bench role, baka makatulong sa kanya kasi he'll go up against the second unit of
second
the
unit.
So if he's out a little above the other players, so mas makakuha siya ng opportunities to perform.
Oo. Correct. Diba? Pero so, for me, siguro you guys give him a few more games. See how this bench role affects him before deciding.
Oo. Kasi baka lumaming din yan si McDermott eh.
Oo nga.
Ay, pag lumaming yan, baka naman
si... Hindi baka. Sure.
Most likely, may yung point na lalamig yan. Alright, Royce O'Neal. Ito, matagal na natin itong binabanggit. Royce O'Neal. Minsan nakikita ko pa ito sa waiver.
Sabi ko nga sana kung maka 4 points si Royce O'Neal. Minsan 0 ngayon yung other game niya. 0 points, 10 rebounds. Huwag nyo i-drop. Kasi yung rebounds, yung steals, yung blocks, yung threes, yan ang specialty niyan eh. Hindi siya mag-score ng 20 points, 15 points for you. Pero the other stats and the all-around production is what he gives you. So, for me, sana they'll be more patient with Royce O'Neal. Sayang eh.
Pero kasi pag mga 14 team, 16 team, pag 14 team, 12 teams pala, medyo ano na to, borderline siguro.
14, he's 14, ano siya?
Kasi sa mga ibang 14 teams ko, nakikita ko nadadrop pa to si Royce O'Neal.
Sa 14 team, dapat naka-roster siya. You should be roster. Sa 12 team, sige, I would give na parang sige borderline. So like Jeremy Lamb, parang ganun. Pero, pag roto, there's no reason you should not roster him. Yun na lang. Parang ganun.
And last player sa buy players or waiver wire specials natin, si Bruce Brown.
Ito, monitor
ko. Start ha, si Bruce Brown today.
Yun nga eh. Walang DeAndre for, ewan ko, kasi personal reasons. I don't know what happened. Pero ang snart nila si Bruce Brown.
Si center.
Yes. But could be matchup based kasi Draymond lang naman ang center ng kalaban. But he might get a big boost in the minutes department. Dahil wala si DeAndre. So monitor na lang nila.
Nabanggit mo na rin Draymond dahil si Draymond buntik na ma-injure, di ba?
Oh, na-injure siya actually.
Pero bumalik siya.
Oo. So, monitor din yan.
So, abangan nyo rin an update if makakalaro siya. But, mukhang okay naman siya. Mukhang he's fine. Mukhang he won't miss time. Pero, may possibility pa rin he might rest it. Depende sa kung
nag-maga
or nag-swell, di ba? So, just hintayin lang natin kung anong balita from si Draymond kung anong, pero definitely hindi naman the drops si Draymond eh. So
hindi.
Abang lang kayo, pero yung magiging beneficiary doon if he misses time is si Toscano
and Wiseman is coming back already, so
confirmed na ba?
Next week, yes.
Okay, nice.
One week daw. So, 1 week from yesterday. So, next week. Mga end of next week, lalaro.
So, medyo nawawala na yung nag-close na yung buy low opportunity.
Oo. Yan ang dapat napunin.
Actually, hindi pa naman nag-close. Pero, maybe if the first game back niya, hindi siya masyadong gumawa, then it can be an opportunity.
Correct.
Pero, mabilisan lang yan kasi baka next game gumawa.
True. Ito magandang sana try nila to be aggressive to get Wiseman.
Yeah.
I have a good feeling.
Sabi na namin, baka mamaya, hindi nyo pa. Meron tayo, favorite, si Romulo sa mga followers natin. Pag nakikinig yan dito, a-attack agad yan pag may narinig.
Sana. Tingnan natin kung paano niya i-execute yan.
Oo, oh, dami niya na-execute ng mga trades na pag narinig niya dito, execute agad eh.
Oo. Magandang ano yan. Magandang target yan.
Oo. So, yan. Those are the buy players natin for today. Nothing really too special or exciting, di ba? Yung mga prospects natin. Kasi parang konti lang rin naman yung mga games today. Pero ito, dito tayo sa worry players. RJ Barrett.
Yun nga eh, nakaka-worry.
Alam nyo ba, RJ Barrett?
Ilang beses na natin nalagay sa worry eh.
Try and trade him or include him in a package if you're trading someone.
Oo.
Might as well, isama mo na yan si RJ Barrett as the kicker.
Oo.
I don't think kayang i-trade si RJ Barrett by himself. Na siya lang yun nandun. Medyo mahirap.
Low I end. Very low end. If you want some low end deal. Pero, if you can trade him, I suggest you trade him. He's just not an efficient player. Right now, who would you rather have? RJ Barrett or Josh Jackson?
Ito pa yung problem. Ito pa yung problem for... Although it's not... hindi niya ka-possession itong mga mabanggiting kong names. Pero like sina Elfrid Payton, sina Derrick Rose are playing really well. So that is up to the usage ni RJ Barrett.
Hindi, ano rin kasi, si Derrick Rose plays shooting guard, actually.
Yun nga.
More than point guard. So, yun, nakaka-affect talaga kay Barrett. If Rose is hot, hindi na, not like the start of the season, Barrett gets all the usage, all the minutes. Bumaba na rin yung minutes.
Oh.
And he's not efficient.
Ang worst yun. Yun yung worst. He's not efficient. Kasi pag tinignan mo
yung... Ito nga yung natanong ko sa'yo eh. Josh Jackson or RJ Barrett?
Josh Jackson?
Eh, yun na nga eh. How
hindi talaga ako fan.
Parang, how far has Barrett fell para mangyari yan? Diba?
Hindi. Ever since naman, he's really not a fantasy-friendly player.
True.
Yeah,
but
let's establish
start.
That. He had a good start.
Pero
did you expect it na magtuloy?
But he's ano eh. Sophomore year pa lang yan, di ba?
Oh, yeah. Well,
yeah, so ako naman kasi I give these young players a little benefit of the doubt. Baka sakali, di ba? Baka sakaling nagbago, nakapag-improve.
Hindi, ito lang rin. He is not really known to be a scorer.
True. Actually, diba? He's a scorer. He's not known to be a
shooter.
Shooter.
Nung college ba, scorer siya?
Scorer siya. Scorer talaga yan. Mostly, bully ball. Yun ang laro ni RJ Barrett.
Pero, pagdating niya sa pros, hindi na niya, maliit na siya eh.
Yun nga. So, I was hoping na nagbago, nagkaroon ng shooting. But I guess, wala pa.
And wala again, pa. Yung some of the guards ng New York are playing well rin. Sina Quickly, Elfrid Payton, even Derrick Rose is playing well.
Ang dami pa. May Alec Burks pa yan. Meron pa yung Austin Rivers. Ang dami.
Oh, so,
may Reggie Bullock pa.
Oh, starting pa, diba?
Gumagawa
start
din.
Si Bullock, naka 3-3 pa. So, trade yun ito, si RJ Barrett. If you could package him with someone, isabay na na. Yung parang ang style dyan is tipong kunyari pag ayaw pumayag nung ka-trade mo dun sa offer mo, isama ko na to si RJ Barrett.
Yun. Para makuha mo lang.
Tapos hingi ka na lang ng someone low end na pwede na won't damage your efficiencies. So, sige, kunin ko na lang si ganito para kay RJ Barrett. Mga TJ McConnell, pwede yan. Baka may pull.
Baka.
Kasi low-end player yan si TJ McConnell eh. Once na hindi siya gumawa, one game, pwede niya na i-try. Kasi may name
yun.
Value si RJ Barrett eh. Si TJ McConnell, wala. Hindi siya a sexy player to own.
True. Correct. Agree ako doon.
Pwede niyong gamitin yun.
Actually, kahit si Eric Gordon eh. I mean, feeling ko. Kung may isang
package
si Gordon, pwede niyo i-try.
Oo.
Not now. Kasi syempre, may
init pa. So, yun, RJ Barrett, DeAndre Ayton, balik na naman sa worry
kasi,
list.
Kasi si Ayton, he's rebounds and blocker there, pero it's not the elite level na Capela level for him to get to the second round value.
Do you think abot pa dun?
Hindi, I don't think so. It's not in him yet. Wala pa.
Kasi hindi ito, ko, ano, early on, during the drafts, he's right there with ano, John Collins, di ba? Yung mga...
21 siya. He was ADP was 21.
Yan, di ba? So, close. Second round value. Parang John Collins. Borderline first round, second round, di ba? Si John Collins has slowly made his way up there. Slowly. Si Ayton, parang malayo-layo pa eh. 60 plus round siya
ngayon
eh.
And I don't think aabot siya doon. Yun na lang. Kaya ko rin nagay din dito. I don't think... He has to average what? 14-15 rebounds, probably 2-2.5 blocks. Kasi wala eh, wala naman nag-improve eh. He doesn't have the 3-pointers pa rin. Scoring niya.
He's not a scorer. He's not known to be a scorer plus.
Well, we expect ng lahat was he was gonna average at least 17-18 points, maybe even 20. People were expecting that Chris Paul nandyan.
Pero
wala. Hindi talaga eh. So, I think because of that,
ang arrival ni Chris Paul has benefited Mikal Bridges. Yung mga ganyan type. Hindi talaga si Ayton.
Pero totoo yun. So, si Ayton, you have to adjust his, ano na lang, his...
Your expectation.
Rest of season rankings, maybe at the 40th. 40 pick, top 40, mga ganun. If that happens, that would be good already.
Pero may name value to si Ayton. So, if you want to trade Ayton, for a more
I'd rather have Capela. I'd rather have Drummond. Oh, even if Drummond is struggling.
Pwede nyo na, kasi may name value yan, kahit na ganyan performance yan. One good game, medyo aangat agad yan. Kasi may, ay, ito niyan, okay yan, diba?
True.
So, may hirapan to trade. Like si Barrett, may name value nga, pero it's not on the good, ano, walang hindi good yung reputation.
Correct.
Diba? So, so yun, yung DeAndre Ayton, definitely, yun yung mga pwede nyong gawin with if you have DeAndre Ayton and hindi kayo wasa performance. Alright, so yun, that's it. That's the roundup of today's games and medyo the Valentine's games. Medyo konti lang yung games today. Tomorrow would be mas marami, so mas exciting. I would, and it's Judgment Day tomorrow. Judgment Day of Week 8. So, aabangan natin yan. Hopefully, ano ka ba ako? Marami ka bang wins?
Wala, derog ako eh. Lahat? Actually, di ko pa na-check kung anong standing namin. Kasi natuwa ako dun sa DFS eh. Yun na medyo napansin ko kanina.
Natuwa eh. Medyo, sali kayo guys. Ang daming sumasali. And,
pero ang alam ko, durog ako. So, yun na yun.
Pero okay lang eh. No? May ano naman eh. May balik
okay na
naman eh. Diba? So, shout out tayo sa DFS boy si Miguel Peralta. Shout out natin yan. Who we guested in the weekly episode. So, pakinggan nyo rin yun. Alright, that's it for our Daily Fantasy Quickie. We'll see you again tomorrow. Happy Valentine's everyone. And enjoy your Sunday. Bye guys.
Bye.